I just want, for me, with stuff like this, I just want a line drawn, like a cutoff. Like, hey, what's acceptable? You have to have at least X number of costumes for your fighting characters stock from the game. And then if you, after that, if you want to add bonus costumes, that's fine. You know what I'm saying? But I don't want them to, hey, here's Street Fighter. Everyone has two costumes. And then from then on out, everything else.
One?
Well, one costume with colors, right? Yeah. Is that what it was?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Two costumes, as in
they just
player
released
one,
another pack
player
or something.
Two. So you come in with two costumes, and then everything else you have to buy. So is that what's? I want a line drawn. Like, so okay, from now on, every fighting game you have one costume, and all your extra costumes you have to buy. Or hey, you know, there's got to be some rule where it's like, hey, you at least have to give them like three or four
costumes.
I'm
sure the developer
would
argue that that's the price that people are paying for spending all their money on used games as opposed to buying.
Well, so let's use this topic to like transition to news, and mm-hmm. I have a question to ask you as far as, because he brought up the idea of like, was Prologue a paid demo? So, you know, the Dead Rising game is coming out with like... Dead Rising 2 is coming out with this story thing that they're going to be charging money for. It's like where you're going to be able to, it's actual Dead Rising 2 engine stuff. Like, you're going to be able to download and play through this, like, sort of like Chapter Zero.
Oh, really?
You know what?
This is before the game. This is before the game comes out.
Before the game comes out, you're going to be able to, what do they call it? Like,
so it's like,
what
do
they call it? Dead Rising Case Zero or whatever.
Okay, it's like a pre-game demo DLC.
That's the thing. They're charging $5 for this. Everybody's like, oh, wow, that's actually a really good deal. I was worried that this was going to be $10. But honestly, this is just their Dead Rising 2 demo.
But then again,
and they're charging money for
but
it.
But it's something you're not going to have to rehash and replay when you actually pick up the retail
But
copy.
I mean, was
is
Dead
that
Rising
what
1's demo was? It's not like you were playing...
What is exactly Case Zero? It's a story, or is it not a story sequence?
If it adds on a story...
It had story stuff to it, but, I mean, that could just have been a prologue that they cut from the regular game as far as the story goes. I think this is a glorified demo that they're going to make money off of.
It's really hard to say, because, first of all, if it's new content that you're not going to get rehashed when you play the actual game, I would say, in that regard, it's an interesting concept because it's new content. But... it's also one of those things where it's like they could also have released it for free and made that their demo, and then the game came. Like, and then
well,
you just pay for the full game.
See, here's the thing, and that's where all the questions come up: is like, when did they come up with this idea? What if this was originally, well, maybe not, but what if this was originally in the game? And they're just like, hey, if we slice this little section off the front of the game, we could just make that DLC, and we could make people pay for that. Same as like. Something where, you know, there's some games that, oh, let's download the ending. You have to download and play the ending. Prince of Persia, for example. I don't know. I never beat Prince of Persia. And when I started the game, one of the first things Brad said to me this week was like, oh, you know.
Wait a second. So.
Good job. Good luck paying for the ending.
But I mean.
Was the ending even.
You didn't pay for it?
No, I played.
It's what follows up at. It's the follow up to the twist. I mean, to the unfinished
ending.
Did
you hear anything about it in terms of like. Did it? Was it a more satisfying?
I love how you're like holding the Prince of Persia
because
case.
Let's not debate this.
Well, see, that's my question.
We gotta fuck.
Did you
price.
Play it though?
No.
See, that's why, and then that's another thing that came to my mind. I was like, dude, if I beat this game, I'm not gonna fucking pay for a DLC ending. What
should
the
I,
fuck
should,
is that?
Should
think about as like on back on the Case Zero. Think about all the games that have started out with sort of these prologues that are somewhat different than. What you get in the main game, maybe you're playing as a different character or that character in a different time
so
setting.
No, you're talking like a dark void kind of, hey,
sure,
here's
exactly.
A little mini NES game. I'm okay with that. It was for the DSi. It was for
wait,
complete...
No. I'm saying, like, think about all the games that we play that have a prologue act where you're playing as a different character or a different character in a different timeline.
Like a Metal Gear Solid 2 or something.
Like even, I think at the beginning of Dark Void proper... Because that's what I thought you were going into. You played as like this different character. He was all like powered up and shit. You know
I
what
was
I mean?
Gonna, and then later you go
back to like the guy you played throughout the course of the game. I'm saying they could have lopped that off and made that, oh, $5 to play this pre-LC.
It's like
pre-LC.
That's what they're calling it.
Oh, man.
It's like if DICE were to have cut off the beginning of Bad Company 2 where you're playing in the past.
Yeah, I'm saying that happens in so many games.
That's just like, a way, that's a common way to start up a game.
Which,
and that's what I'm saying, this thing that we're paying for might have been just that.
Which sucks because... I would have been pissed if I didn't, because that was probably one of my favorite levels in the game in Bad Company 2, like, just that beginning sequence where you're playing in Japan, like, back in World War II, like, that was crazy.
Exactly.
And it was a cool way to start the game. If I had to pay $5 for that, now that I'm thinking about it, like...
And see, my problem is that everybody's going, bravo, Capcom, you're only charging $5 for this. I thought it was going to be $10. Way to go. And I'm like, maybe these were the guys who charged money for, like, multiplayer in one of their games, and charge $10 for a pack of apples.
You're talking about Resident Evil 5.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just saying, like, maybe this isn't as
revolutionary as it
was. Or maybe this is actually starting a really bad precedent, and we don't realize it.
That's horrible.